Sure. Let's see. It's been running, so it might take me a second to get it sort of scooped. I think I better try a syringe in the needle. It's like a little puddle.
Oh. Probably just deliver it in the syringe.
Oh yeah, you probably could. Let's see how much I can get. Maybe I can scoop some chunks. It's very watery. Try to scoop.
I wonder if I could use just the syringe. Maybe a bigger hole.
I can get a feeding syringe.
There might actually be one in here. That's a good idea. I found one, yeah. Okay. You got the...
Whatever Meadow got last time is included in it, so I think.
Oh,
yeah.
Is that the name of the
answer? Yeah, I think that's
okay.
I think that's
right.
Darner.
D A R N E L.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So fresh.
So fresh.
Do you think Fort Wayne did that?
Okay. I know that was exciting. Where was I? All right, everybody. You're about to meet our newest guest. Nervous pooper. It's okay, buddy. Let me get this. Okay. Sorry, buddy. We tried to make it as unscary as possible. Auntie Brooke is out right now trying to catch your friends. What have you been eating? That's so interesting. Poo. Okay. Hopefully everyone can bear with me for a minute. We're trying to be live on Facebook and YouTube. So I can't quite see everything, but hopefully that's okay. And okay, buddy. Let's see if you're a boy. We think he's a boy. He's got a poopy. Oh yeah. Poopy little bum situation. Sorry, buddy. You're okay. You are okay. Don't have a anyway. Oh, look how handsome he is. He's so handsome. He's so brave. He's so brave. Do you like snacks? Can I bribe you with some snacks? Do you like that? What a good boy. You're okay. You're going to be okay. I know it's scary. So this is one of Bellflower's kittens. We've been sort of keeping an eye on them. Because they looked good and then they started showing some upper respiratory symptoms. So you are here. Very scared, and he's definitely got some poop situations going on, like all of them have had. So when we did talk to our vet, and she okayed us giving some gabapentin, so he does have gabapentin on board, and we let him kind of chill a little bit so that it could kick in, because we're trying to keep his stress level as low as possible. And so I'm just giving him some Revolution for fleas and ear mites and worms. He has very subtle testicles, if any, but I'm not going to. I have to clean up his bum before I do any groping back there, so I'm gonna wait on that since I have to do other things. I'm gonna start some nice eye drops for him, because his eyes look sore. Eyes look sore. This will help them be less sore. I know that's when we were watching this left eye. And finally we couldn't just watch anymore. And since our grassroom kittens got adopted and are getting to go home, boy, looks good underneath all that inflammation though. Such a good kitten. You're such a good kitten. Can you look in your mouth? We'll have to do a thorough. It's pretty bright in this room at the moment, so
Might be hard to see ringworm. He sounds congested. Can I get a picture of your face? Because it's so cute. What a good boy. What a good boy. Maybe if we cover you up, I can see if. And hide in there. Are you blowing some snot bubbles? You reached this way. Here's a Kleenex for you. I know. There, just wipe your little snotty nose. You're very cute. Such a big sigh. See if he has anything obvious. Actually, I may as well toothbrush him while I do this. Everyone we've brought in from this colony, all the kittens have had ringworm. So I'm just going to collect a sample. We'll send to the lab. Just let everyone know that we will have a ringworm PCR sample in addition to the very runny poop sample. Is that a little flea friend? Not for long. Your little toesies are dirty. You're a very good boy. You're very brave. You're being very brave. See, this part's not so bad. It doesn't hurt. It feels kind of good. I know it's scary, but... For those of you watching on Facebook, you can go to our live stream, tinykittens.com/live, and there will be closed captioning and... Our mods are there, and it may be a better view, I'm not sure. You're so handsome and such a good boy. I'm sorry I have to do all this invasive stuff to you, but we did at least give you some good drugs. Good drugs first. You have a wormy belly. Lots of worms in there. You're very handsome though. We've been spying on you with our cameras for quite a while. This is the bunch that Homer was with. But Homer's much littler. Well, actually he's probably about the same size at this point, but he's younger. Hi. Oh, hi there. He was quite a bit smaller. I got distracted by your dirty ears. Oh, yay. Awesome. Okay, cool. Now I have to just keep doing your sample. So I'm trying to look for lesions, ringworm lesions. And I haven't seen any obvious ones so far. I don't think Homer actually had obvious lesions when he came in, but
he ended up with the ringworm kittens because he needed little friends his age. I'm gonna have to, you're so dirty. This toothbrush is filthy. It's filthy. You're being very brave, and I'm extremely proud of you. I'm very proud of you. This kind of feels like mom. Your mom was a very good mom. She protected you. She kept you safe. She took such good care of you. I'm sorry, I have to get your belly again a little bit better. It would be amazing. I'm not going to even jinx us, but because I'm sure that he has something. I'm so sorry, I have to pluck some hairs from you because you're not shedding enough. What a monster. We don't get enough of a sample, then they will reject it, and then we won't get results. So I have to get lots of hairs. I have to get some from your beets. Oh, you're being very good. I hope soon you will have some friends to snuggle with. So Auntie Brooke is out. He has 3 siblings, and so she's out trying to trap the others. The cameras are very helpful because they let us figure out how many kittens there are, who the mom is, what their habits are, so we kind of know when they're active and when they're not active, and we were able to figure out where their nest was. You're doing so good. Okay, we're getting there. We're getting there. I'm sorry. Your hair is nicely anchored so that it's hard to get out. I know, what a monster. At least you've got some good drugs on board. He's more scared than spicy, but hopefully that will change pretty quickly. You're being very good boy. I need more. I need to harvest more fluff from you. I'm so sorry. I know. There, I think that will be closer. There's nothing worse than waiting 5 days to get results and then having it come back with insufficient sample. I'm sorry, I know it's a moon there. I think that'll be enough for me. I need one more. You will forgive us one day, I think. You're very handsome.
Now I could get a better, even a better sample. I don't see anything moving. It's just very watery. All right. Auntie Gwen's gonna come pick up your, let's see if I can at least, oh, that's, he somehow shot it actually inside my sleeve there. I just don't necessarily want his liquid poop oozing down my arm and contaminating all of me. Can you just stand there for a minute while I regroup? He shot poop inside my sleeve. Oh. I'm just trying to. I know, poor little guy. Okay, this is the toothbrush.
Perfect.
Can you reach the wipes and just sort of toss them in this direction? Or yeah, and then I don't have to be perfect. Then I don't have to be touching him with my poop fingers. Thank you.
Do you want some different wipes? You can jump or are you okay?
Are there shirt? Some down here? Then I can wipe his bum. Thank you. Poor little guy. Okay, awesome. I just don't want to be putting my poopy fingers in his ears or mouth or anything like that. I could wear gloves, but they would be very compromised at this point. Okay, little monster. Little poop monster. Anyhow, it's gonna get better. Okay, it's not always gonna be scary, I promise. And soon, hopefully, your horse will be here. We have excellent snacks also. Okay. Alright, let's see about cleaning your ears, because you may enjoy that a little bit. You're very stinky. Does that feel good? You're being very brave. I'm sorry, this is scary. It's good that we have a fresh poop sample so we can get him started. We always learn things when we have colonies. We learn what pathogens they have, and then we can get very efficient with that. Oh, thank you.
Something we want to put in there. There's nothing in there.
Okay.
So like warm water. And these are wet
clothes. Oh, amazing. Thank you.
These are dry.
Oh, yay.
Imagine his hair wants to wash.
Yeah, he's pretty dirty.
Shall I put a couple drops of this?
Oh, sure. That would be great. Thank you.
I'll start with that and then I'll let you decide if
yeah.
More of that in there.
Amazing.
And I will get you a written spot.
Okay. Thank you. Ease into cleaning you so that you don't get too
too scared. Nice warm water. I hope you're, have you emptied your bowels? I hope that I don't clean you and then you get scared again and poop. And then you're trying to sneaky sneak away. It's a weird experience having someone wash your tail. Give you a little lime salt dip. Probably not till your friends are all here and then you can all go at the same time. I just don't want you to have to sit in your poop. Because it's so runny. Such runny poop. And quite stinky. His belly does smell like he's good. As I walk, as I wake him. Poor little dude. I wonder what he's been eating. All sorts of interesting little bits and bobs in there.
Oh, poor guy. Twigs and sticks.
Yep. All right, thank you.
He'll probably be eating lime salt for that tomorrow.
Yeah, I think so. I'll get as much as I can.
Maybe this is not like his bowel sore?
It doesn't look sore.
Okay. We don't need that.
No, I don't think so. Okay. No. I think he's okay.
Alright.
Just try to clean around it without creating more. Interesting. We've been eating an interesting diet, although we have been feeding them baby cat food. But they've also been learning. Their mama has been teaching them how to hunt. So they've probably been eating little bugs and critters and things. All right, we'll just clean your ear a little bit. And then I do want to look in your mouth. Check for oral ulcers and see if there's anything alarming. Check your gums. Check your teeth. All those things. Your color looks excellent. You look hydrated. Your capillary refill is good. Can I see in there? Can I see that again? Good job. If I'm gonna do that, I should put some of this in there, don't you think? The churro tax. Oh, we like that. We like that a lot. Should we have a little delicious snack? Can we eat it more? There we go. That's good. There you can see. I bet if I put it in a syringe, you would eat it. This is a very tiny syringe. I've made a big mess. A big mess. As usual. Let's try this. Good job. Okay. Well, that's good. He at least likes snacks. Okay, so mouth. He had some ulcers on the back of his tongue. But not bad. They look like they're healed. Hydration looks pretty good. We're gonna hold off on the vaccine until he's feeling a little bit better, because we don't want to stimulate his immune system when it's already stimulated and struggling. So, and he's doing well on his gabapentin. Discharge. Weight is 1.03 kilograms. Body condition is like a 3 probably. Yes, he's all belly. But not too, it could be worse. It could be worse. Nose has discharge. He was black light negative, although it is quite bright in here, so I'm not necessarily going to. Let's see if this sees anything different. This might be better. Oh, did you just burp? What a handsome boy. You're so handsome and so brave. You're being so brave. You're very stinky too. You're so stinky. I'm sorry, can I look at your belly again? Let's move this out of the way. Be very brave. I'll do this part fast, okay? Not the most thorough. Let me just wipe your little feeties, okay? Let's get you a clean layer of a poop sheet. Your poop sheet here. Let's do that. Okay, I'm not gonna check his testicles yet, because we'll just wait until
got his poops a little more under control. You're being very brave. Okay. I think that's pretty good. That's probably as good as we're gonna get. You're being so good. Okay. Since he's on the gavel, though, I am going to bug tape him. I'm just going to blood type him quickly because we will help us understand what his mom's blood type is potentially and way. It's just the very tiniest little droplet of blood. The big sigh. Soon you will forget this day even happened. And you will enjoy all the delicious snacks, and we have good toys. Okay. Let's cover you up, and then we'll show your new, all your friends. These are all your new friends, okay? You have so many fans. You don't even know it. You don't even know how many people love you already. And we're all excited to see you blossom and to see you feel better. And hopefully we'll meet your siblings later today. Or at least one of them. We're hoping for at least one so that he doesn't have to spend a night alone. But we definitely wanted to bring him in and get his treatment started because he was looking a little bit rough around the edges. You can look at his database, his catalog page, and see what he looked like. He actually looks better than I was expecting. Yes. You are. You look much better than I was expecting. So, good job. So, he's having, he's been dewormed now, and we're going to hold off on dipping. We're trying to sort of ease him into the stressful things to see if that helps contain any flare-ups. There we go.
type B, so I assume bellflower is a B, but we have found with this colony that kittens can be a combination of blood types, like Scotia is type A, and she had all A kittens, but one was B, so I think they have a strong B subtype even in the A cats. But we have about 50% type B blood for the cats in this colony, which is very unusual. Okay, buddy. I'm gonna put you back. We did get a blanket scented for him out there. So he has his scented blanket. So I'm gonna put him on that, and then I'm gonna have to get some clean things to cover him up. And then, and so, yeah, so we'll see. So, I don't know. We may do more live intakes if his little friends come in.
Oh, look, he's so cute.
Oh, he's very cute. Oh, big sigh. So I'm gonna let him rest and not stress him out too much. But hopefully he will have company by tonight. But otherwise tomorrow. Oh, we've got, here is Auntie Brooke sending some pictures from the field. That's Franck. That's his, we think brother Franck in the front there. So hopefully Franck will be joining you soon. Okay, well, thank you everybody for tuning in. You can check back for updates on Facebook or the live streams, tinykittens.com/live. And hopefully we will get the rest of them. I haven't done this on the iPad before, okay. Be very good. Oops. Okay, so anyway, I'm gonna put you guys on the live stream back on Scotia because it's just gonna be nothing too exciting down here. He'll probably just hide. One of the headlamps that gets stuck in the hair. And my headband.